There's a seriously heavy storm going on, and now there's thunder, so that's great. Sup everyone, I'm your female otaku, and I'm here to review episode 4 of Sword Oratoria. And you guys may notice a new look once again! You know, I've been testing out a bunch of new looks this entire week and stuff, seeing what works best, because I want the quality of the videos to look far better than they always have, because, you know, it's always a little grainy and stuff in the back, especially, like, with the black background, it's always kind of grainy, so I was able to get a light, but now the background looks kind of dark. I don't know, maybe I'm able to color correct it or something. I don't know. I'm just working things out. We'll see how it goes, okay? I'm just testing it out this one time. Maybe it'll stick, maybe it won't. Let me know if you prefer this, if you like the light or not, and yeah. But anyway, with this episode of Sword Oratoria, honestly made me question if this was even Don Machi. Like, honestly, this was something completely different from everything else that we have seen over in Don Machi before. I mean, it has gotten serious, but not to this extent where we saw someone strangle a man to death. I am really loving Sword Oratoria. I mean, I've told you guys my complaints already. Mainly it's with, you know, Lafia, but everything else I am really enjoying. This season, if you want to call it a season, this spin-off is just far better than Don Machi, like, as of late. I know some may disagree, but hey, I guess let me know. Do you prefer Don Machi? Do you prefer Sword Oratoria? Is it too early to say? But anyway, I'm so happy that we're diving more into Aiz's past. It was just a small bit, but you know what? I will take what I can get, and there's still plenty more episodes to go, so we're probably gonna learn more about Aiz. This is something that a lot of us have been wanting for a long time. Aiz's backstory, and we get a hint of it. We see her as a child, absolutely adorable, but we see her as a child, and her mother is telling her, like, a story, and how, like, her mother hopes that Aiz can find her true love, and then we see this guy, and this guy is hoping that Aiz can find her true hero, so I'm just like, what? A level 4 adventurer has been murdered, and it's by this woman who we haven't seen before, so even more villains are being brought into this mess. We have, you know, that one god, again, I forget his name, I know it starts with a D, I think it's like Dionysus, I probably got it wrong, but anyway, so this god, he comes back once again, and it was made clear to us last week that he's most likely the person that has been creating these new type creatures, but he tells Loki, which I know there's definitely some lies in there, but there's definitely some truth as well. He tells Loki that he has just been researching the newfound creatures because 3 of his familia members have been murdered. So I do believe that his familia members have been murdered. However, I think that he's not really investigating the creatures. He's the one that's creating the creatures and is testing them, and, well, did test them on a few of his familia. I gotta say, I really enjoyed that scene with Bete and how he was, like, you know, joking around with, like, Loki. Well, he wasn't really joking around. In fact, he was rather annoyed with Loki, which a lot of you seem to really hate Loki. Honestly, I can understand. I don't really hate her. I do find her annoying, but that's kind of the point of her character. She's definitely supposed to be a nuisance, and it's really irritating. None of the other characters really like her. So, I don't know. I guess I'm just playing along with the characters. But anyway, so like I said, I really enjoyed that scene with Bete fighting, because we found out that Bete can actually use a magic weapon. I mean, I'm sure all of them can use a magic weapon, but we just haven't seen all of them use one. We've only just seen, like, Bete, we've only just seen him, you know, kick things, really. And this time he has, like, this blade, and he activated, like, I guess his shoes or something like that. And the man was on freaking fire. So, like, literally, the man was on freaking fire. So that was pretty awesome to see. And then we end the episode with Aiz and Lafia finding this girl named Lunune, who is kind of in this mess a little bit. She's a little bit in this mess with the whole murder, because her quest was to get this item from the murdered victim. And she already got the item, and so when the item was revealed to be some sort of strange creature in a glass ball, Aiz freaked the fuck out, but Lafia was fine. So maybe Lafia's fine because, you know, she's a mage, and, you know, magic properties, they probably just deactivate whatever the creature's, like, trying to do on others. I don't really know, but Aiz was heavily affected, and she was going bonkers, man. Oh my god, that was weird to see. I never thought I would see Aiz make that face ever. And then those creatures pop up once again, those flowerish snake ones. So who is this woman? What the heck is going on? And I'm really enjoying this ride. So let me know your thoughts on this episode and catch you later as I review Rage of Bahamut Virgin Soul. I'm your female otaku, Sayonara.